Let me say that FEP as a group, we are proud to say that from nothing, 2002, and I would actually say up to 2007, we are just laying the foundations. In a nutshell, to say, to cut the story short, from 2002, we were 56 members by 2006. That was the foundational stages when we were just discussing it can happen, researching, laying the foundations. And I normally say, as an architect, one thing I was told, never worry about foundations. Set your foundations right. No matter how long you spend on the foundations, if anything, people say that the deeper the foundations, the higher you, you shall go. Mm-hmm. So therefore, we spent our 4 years, 2002, 2006, being sure that does the formula work? Is it possible? Is it practical? And that's why we were just a group of 56. Then 2007, we started inviting friends. And I would say that the number grew from 56 to 1,207 by 2011. By 2013, the number grew to 37,000. I also want to say that by end of last year, we had 63,000 investors within our framework. But by and large, we have the club we call Fountain Enterprises Program, where everybody must be a member to know, just to know what happens before you get converted, do you want to invest? And within that organization, we have 174,000 members, where it's just a club we come together and we meet often just to share ideas on entrepreneurship, about business, about the formula, how it works, and sharing experiences. Yes. But then the people now who can say they have engaged and say, now I know, now I want to be part of, I'm part of this group in terms of investment, is 63,000 investors.
I lead the management team of FEP Holdings. My job and the rest of my team is to create value for you investors. Our job is to prudently manage the organization resources. It is to drive the strategy of the group. It is to come up with mechanisms to ensure we are generating profits, that we are growing the business for your benefit. I would like to give a number of messages to you. We've come up with a very important theme for this year's AGM, which is coming together. Because FEP, based on the power of many, is all about coming together, bring the communities together, bring those who are able, and give them a platform to be able to help those who are not able. It is about giving a platform for those with the competencies to be able to generate wealth for all the communities. And therefore, as I welcome all the investors today, I have to say that we are happy to see that all the investors have come together. And this will be a special occasion for us, because we're not just having investors coming from different counties. We're not just having investors coming from the diaspora. We also have new investors amongst us. As you are aware, with the PPO exercise, we created what we call a RAM, which was to enable members who are not already shareholders in the company to come. And I'm pleased to notice that half of those who participated were from the RAM. And therefore, that is a sign that we are really, really coming together. Secondly, we as a management have made a lot of changes for your benefit. We've looked at the business, done the reorganizations. We've had a good, although in some respects challenging 2014, but at least we are here, you know, working together to deliver value to you. Again, it is a coming of the old and the new that is coming together for us. This organization has a very rich history. It has very powerful vision. It has very, very strong values based on the Christian faith. And those are values that we believe will last forever. We want to combine that with a new way of doing business. We've launched a new FEP corporate organization. And that's what we like to refer to that as FEP corporate has now come alive. And we believe merging that with our rich legacy of values is going to take this organization to new heights.
My message to investors is that we are really staring at a very interesting time where we are going to really take off as a business. The future holds opportunities for us that we are only just beginning to tap in. By 2020, we expect that for the supermarkets, we'll be positioned in more than 20 locations and spread across the country and in many of the counties. So watch out for our supermarket coming next to you very soon. Where we're expanding our footprint in all the locations, rebranding into Santec and able to communicate our products with our investors and also our clients who walk into our business. Our insurance agency is going to extend and move from a brokerage. Currently it's an insurance agency. We're going to grow it into an underwriter over the next 5 years, and we'll be offering all products in-house, and all the work that comes within that will be retained within the business rather than take it outside. And you've seen quite a big potential using our captive market of our members and investors to really have a platform that you can move into that next level of business. As FTM, we're currently present in Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, and Ghana. Some of the major clients who we are servicing is Safaricom, Airtel, Nokia in Kenya, and in Uganda and Tanzania, we're currently working with Alcatel and Huawei. It's going through a massive expansion process in Tanzania and Uganda, and we are part of that story, and we are one of the people who are some of the biggest contractors in the projects. In Ghana, we are also present. We are quite involved in a lot of civil work and telecom, and we have recently just won a significant solar solution project in Ghana, where we are providing solar for ATMs for a particular bank. There's a big challenge in solar electricity solutions in Ghana, and we are part of the solution where we are offering that, and we are one of the major providers of that solution. For the microfinance, we're going to increase our loan book and product offering, currently slightly less than half a billion to excess of 2 billion in terms of financing. So really the future for us is quite positive for investors. And we urge you to have commitment and put all your investment in FEP, because that's where the future is. That's where we're going at the moment. And we are very positive in terms of how that team is going to work. We have a very vibrant and young team that is very ambitious, working under the close stewardship of our COO and our CEO, Dr. John Githaka, where you're going to drive all these initiatives with the support of the board. So this is where to be, and this is the moment to be in FEP. If there's no other time, this is it. And to you, our investors, I want us to remember one thing. If you want to go fast, you travel alone. If you want to go far, let's travel together. Let's remember FEP Group works through the power of many. With the power of many, we can cover distances that we haven't before. With the power of many, stronger together, we'll make a difference with the investment, we'll make a difference in your life. Let's work together, stronger together, it's the power of many.
The truth is that we are stronger together. There's a lot that we can do when we come together than what an individual person is able to achieve. And therefore, through the wide network of FEP investors, we can be able to do much more than what each individual person is able to do. At the same time, I would request each of our members, and indeed every investor, to give us an opportunity to serve them. Bring your children to us, buy land from us, and come for housing needs from us. When you need to relax and go out on holiday or travel around, come to us to Fountain Safaris. When you need your child well educated, come to our schools, and we promise that we will give you the very best of service to ensure that you get value for money. All your security needs, come to Citadel. You have a premises that needs to be given security, CCTV, guarding, and all manner of security solutions. Citadel is there to do that for you. Property management, come to Kisima Real Estate. We are able to make sure that we collect the rents for you, manage the property for you, and take off the hassle from you of always looking for your tenants. are to give you your money at the end of the month. Kisima Real Estate is also in the business of helping seal the housing deficit in this country. It is estimated that up to 150,000 housing units are required in Kenya alone. And it is also estimated that only 30,000 units of houses are availed to the Kenyan population in every single year. And because of this, we intend to engage with partners to ensure that we are able to construct houses for our investors. Those who have bought land through us, we intend to start housing schemes that will make them have the homes that they deserve and that they always have wanted to own. And one of the things that we hope to do with Kisima is to have the diaspora buy land through us. Many people in the diaspora would want to relocate back to this country, and we believe that we should be able to give them a house when they get back home. And as you do this, as you give us the opportunity to serve you, we are generating a return for you. Not only a return that is current, but a return that is sustainable. That's our promise to each of our investors.
Today we have a portfolio of more than 5 billion in terms of portfolio, and I can say this is just a beginning. That we said from very far that 2015 is the only time Kenyans will discover these guys meant something, and we told people from 2002 that the year 2015 will be the year of vision. It is the year people will say, "Aya, you mean these guys had an idea." So we told people that 2015 is the only year we shall come to a point of visibility. And therefore, I would say that with the 5 billion, our strategy is to be worthy not less than 100 billion in the next 2-3 years. And I'll tell you, in the next 5 years or so, by 2020, we want to be the story of the biggest and the fastest growing and the most innovative investment conglomerate in the East African region. And I want to believe that this generation is going to witness what Kenyans united for one common agenda called investment can do together through a group that is innovatively tied together, a group run by men and women of integrity, that people can believe that we have leaders who people can believe in. We have a team people can believe in, and of course appreciating that the power of global networking. It means that we don't just come together to bring money. We come together to bring ideas together, to bring synergies, and also be able to help each other appreciate what is happening across the globe to enable us to move faster and appreciating the dynamism in the current economic arena.
Today is a great day because we have the annual general meeting, and we are receiving all the investors to brief them on what we have been doing for the last 1 year, and to give them opportunity to also discuss with us and bring in new ideas they may have seen. Because as you know, our philosophy is power of many. These investors are the same people who trained within FEP, and they have very good feedback to give us. As a board, we are constituted by the Articles of Association. We are 9 of us, people of various backgrounds. As I've seen, I'm an engineer with a lot of experience on public administration and also governance. We have among us accountants and financial experts. We have educationists. We have lawyers. We have human resource practitioners, we have agriculturalists, and the board is fully compliant within the governance and very well established with all the competencies. The board works as a team. We are a very united team. Since we started working as Ambod in 2010, we have never had incidences where we are forced to vote because we can't agree. We always take our decisions unanimously. The board is also very committed. The attendance of the board is over 80% in a year. And you know, these are people who are doing their other businesses. So that is a very, very good commitment of the board. The board has a management team that we work with and who give us feedback. And we find this management team to be very competent, very hardworking, very industrious, and very committed to the cause of working with the FEB. All in all, we are on the right course, and we are doing our best to give the investor value for their investment. My message to the investors today is to just, first of all, to welcome you to this meeting, and secondly, to assure you that your board is overseeing the operations of FEB in the manner it is expected to do. And ours is to appeal to you to continue supporting the activities of FEB. Give it preference. If it is security, please prefer our security services. If it is insurance you want, prefer services from our insurance. If it is financial services, we are there for you. If it is in the hospitality, we are there for you. And if it is there in the real estate, if you want to buy a plot or if you want to build a house, we are there for you. So let us work together. Let us pull together in a united force, and let us make this dream come true. Thank you and God bless you.
Again, this AGM is our fifth AGM. It is very, very phenomenal for us, because being the fifth AGM, we have to think about the next 5 years as we think long term for the organization. Therefore, for us, this organization marks where the past stops and the future begins in terms of merging all those new variables that we've talked about. And we see an organization that is going to grow. We see also an organization that has regenerated. We are going to grow and become one of the largest corporates in this country. Therefore, if there have been any challenges in the past, today, being the AGM date, marks the end of those challenges and really marks the coming of a new organization and a very, very successful one. We are very clear and core to our mission of empowering communities, and we can only do that if we generate value for you investors. We are here today for you. We are here to make to you a promise that from this day of the fifth AGM, we will see nothing but growth, we will see nothing but value created for you. With that, on behalf of the management team of FEB Holdings, I would like to say thank you, and we wish you all the best.